Hello, and welcome to the vCloud Automation Center video, Managing Network Profiles for NSX Integration. In this video, we are going to address the role of network profiles in the vCloud Automation Center and NSX relationship. We will then demonstrate the configuration steps required to define network profiles and address some of the key points to understand when performing network profile configuration. Network profiles perform two main functions. Firstly, network interface configuration. These settings apply equally to virtual machines and NSX edge services routers as part of a multi-machine blueprint deployment. Secondly, the NSX edge services router configuration. Depending on the type of network profiles we define within the multi-machine blueprint, several rules will be configured in the NSX edge services router during deployment. These rules determine how your application networks will interact with external networks, potentially routing, NATing, or dropping traffic. In a more complex deployment, more than one rule set may be configured dynamically during provisioning. Firstly, let's take a look at external network profiles. External networks are primarily used in one of two ways: to pass configuration information to catalog items that are not associated with a multi-machine blueprint, and also to provide information that is used to configure the external interface of our NSX Edge Services Router. As you'll see shortly, external networks are consumed by other network types in order to pass through upstream network service information, such as DNS. This means it is incredibly important to enter the correct information to your external network profile. The IP range information that is configured here acts as a pool of addresses which are passed to workloads during provisioning. When workloads complete their lifecycle, the assigned IP addresses are released back into the pool for reallocation. Network address translation, or NAT, is often used to conserve IP addresses. As you will see, when the external network profile is selected from the drop-down menu, the DNS and WINS information below is inherited from that profile. The only difference between the one-to-one and one-to-many NAT profiles that you see as a selection in the drop-down box is the rule set that is defined on the NSX Edge Services Router. Both DNAT and SNAT will be configured for our one-to-one profile, while for the one-to-many profile, it will be configured with DNAT only. When defining the default gateway value, this is in fact the IP address that will be assigned to the internal interface of our NSX Edge Services Router and acting also as the default gateway for the components that are provisioned below it. IP ranges for both one-to-many and one-to-one NAT networks do not need to be unique, as they are masked by the external IP of the NSX Edge Services Router. Our next step will be to configure a one-to-many NAT profile. One thing you'll note with both of the NAT profiles is that DHCP is a configurable option. Enabling this would configure the NSX Edge Services Router DHCP services to serve out IP addresses. The private network profile is the most straightforward profile of all. When deployed in isolation, the associated NSX Edge Services Router has no external network connectivity, resulting in complete isolation. As you can see, there is no field to associate this profile with an external network, and hence no DNS or WINS configuration fields either. When it is deployed in more complex configurations, such as with a NAT or router profile, then the catch-all deny rule prevents ingress and egress traffic for that network segment. Our final network profile type is the routed network profile. For those of you who are familiar with networking, the router profile will not provide any challenge. For those of you who are not familiar, pay particular attention to the range subnet mask value, which allows you to create several smaller network ranges within the constraint of your defined subnet. The base IP provides the point at which you wish your subnet to start being portioned out. We'll see this working in practice when we go to the IP Ranges tab and select the Generate Ranges button. Unlike NAT ranges, our routed network ranges must be unique. This completes our Managing Network Profiles for NSX integration video. For further information, please see our additional videos, Automated Network Provisioning with NSX Overview, which provides the context of the software-defined data center and the high-level steps required to configure NSX and VCAC for integration. Also, please see Preparing vCloud Automation Center for NSX Integration, where we demonstrate reservation configuration and the steps required to set up multi-machine blueprints to consume NSX resources. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope that it was informative.